DNS name resolution. What does it take to turn that awesome name, www.google.com, or whatever name that you want, into a into an IP address that your computer can use to, you know, do the networking things that it does? Let's talk about it. So what exactly are we talking about? We are talking about when your computer reaches out to whatever DNS server it's been told to reach out to say, hey, what's the IP address for whatever domain name that I want to do? In our case, we're going to use the example of www.schetzler.net, my own website. And so what happens? First of all, your computer reaches out to the DNS server, whatever DNS server it's been told to reach out to, and it says, what's that IP address? The DNS server does not respond, let me find out. It just goes and finds out and then responds, but we're, you know, faking a conversation here. So you know how examples work. There are two different ways that that can happen. The first that we're going to talk about is the full resolver process. This is what happens when a server goes through the entire process and figures out what that domain name is, what the IP address for that domain name is. And at some point, this has to happen no matter which process you use. We're just going to show this example first. The full resolver process, meaning we got to start from scratch. We reach a DNS server that knows nothing about this domain. So first, we have that DNS request that we talked about. So the computer reaches out and says, hey, server, what's the IP address? Where is www.schetzler.net? And the server, again, doesn't say, let me find out. There's no DNS message that's let me find out. The DNS server will respond once it has done its job. And that job starts with the DNS server reaching out to the root name servers. And it reaches out, it figures out where those root name servers are. Remember, DNS is a hierarchy, starts at the root. So we start at the root, and it has to know where that root is because it has a root hints file. This is a file, a text file stored on the server, on a DNS server. And you can go out on the internet and download this file for yourself. I did, that's how I got this awesome screenshot. This file tells us where are the root servers that we need to talk to. What are the IP addresses? So we've got a.rootservers.net, here's the IP address, b.rootservers.net, here's the IP address, and we have IPv4 and IPv6 addresses for those, C, D, E, F, G. They didn't all fit on the screen, so you know that they exist, they're also there. So now that we have the IP addresses of those root DNS servers, remember, this is the DNS server doing this job, the DNS server that our computer talked to ask for this. The DNS server is now resolving, it knows where the root servers are, so now it's going to ask the root name servers, can you tell me where the top-level domain servers are for .NET? Because remember, we're resolving www.schetzler.net, so we need to find, we start at the top, start at the root, next level down is the top-level domain .NET. So where are the top-level domain servers for .NET? The root server knows, or the root servers know, all of those root servers know. So the DNS server asks the root name servers, and the root name servers say, okay, I'll check my root zone file. The root zone file has a list of all of the top-level domains. So the root DNS server is going to look in that root zone file and find the section that is .NET. There's a section for .com. There's a section for .AWS. There's a section for .Ninja or Unicorn or whatever top-level domains exist. And in that file, it says, okay, .NET, these ones are located at a.gtldservers.net, b.gtldservers.net, C, D, E, F, G. These are different from the root files because it's not rootservers.net. This is gtldservers.net. These are new ones. Also in that root zone file is what these mean, because you wouldn't want to tell the server you need to resolve this to resolve this. So we give it a.gtldservers.net, and we also tell it, okay, they're here 192.5.6.30, 192.33.14.30, etc., etc., etc. The whole list there, that list comes back to our name server, and the name server now knows. The root server responds, and it says the .NET top-level domain servers are, here's their IP addresses, here's where you can look, here's who you ask next. And so now the DNS server talks to the .NET top-level domain DNS servers. We have more DNS servers, so many DNS servers responsible for making this work. And the DNS server, our DNS server, talks to the .NET top-level domain DNS server, and it says, can you tell me where the name servers are for Schetzler.net? Who's in charge of Schetzler.net? And when you pay to register a domain, this is what you're paying for. You are paying the .NET top-level domain DNS server to record who's in charge of your servers. So you say that. Who are the name servers in charge of Schetzler.net? The .NET TLD DNS server says, sure, it's pat.ns.cloudflare.com and cache.ns.cloudflare.com. And if we need to, we can go through the whole DNS resolution process to resolve these ones. But we're not going to talk about that. We're just going to assume we already know where pat.ns.cloudflare.com and cache.ns.cloudflare.com are. Those are stored in our DNS cache because we've looked them up before. So where are those? We know where those are. So let's go ask those now. We know the name servers for Schetzler.net. We need www still. So we ask the Schetzler.net name servers for the A record for www.schetzler.net. And the A record for www.schetzler.net is there listed on the Cloudflare name servers. And the Cloudflare name server can say, sure, it's 185.199.111.153. There's your IP address. And so now our DNS server knows the IP address and it can respond and it passes that along back to us. That's the process. We have all sorts of DNS servers involved. We got the root, we got the top-level domain, we got the name servers, we got whatever DNS server our computer asked. Lots of DNS servers needed to make this process work. It's a complicated thing, but it's the system that makes the entire internet work. And now you can see why, when the DNS server gets a response and gets this IP address, it's likely to cache that and store it for a while, because it doesn't want to go through that process the next time someone asks for www.schetzler.net. So it's going to hold on to that record for an hour or 10 minutes or a day or a week or as long as you tell it to hold on to that record. And a longer time to live means that that stays in the cache longer, which means that the next time someone asks, it's likely to be there in the cache and not need to go through that full resolution process again, which saves the DNS server some time, because each of those is a message being sent somewhere in the world that takes some amount of time. So that was our full resolution process. Now we have other DNS servers that aren't full resolvers. They don't do the full resolution thing. They are called forwarders. Perhaps your router is a forwarder and does this process, or perhaps your internet service provider, or perhaps you've set up a pie hole. The pie hole does exactly this and does this forwarding process. What's the forwarding process? Well, it starts out the same. Your computer doesn't know whether the DNS server it's talking to is a forwarder or doing that full resolution. Your computer's just going to reach out just like it did before and ask what the IP address is. The DNS forwarder is, again, not actually saying this, but it's going to go find out. So now the DNS forwarder, what does it do? First thing it does is it asks a resolver. So it just asks someone else to do this process for it. What's the IP address? The DNS server, the DNS resolver that's going through that full process is going to find that out, and it goes through that exact full resolution process that we just talked about, talking to the root, talking to the top-level domain, talking to the name servers, and finally getting those correct records. And finally, once it goes through all that, it responds, it turns that A record back over, and it says, here, DNS forwarder, here's the A record for the thing that you asked for. Here we go. And once it has that, it turns it back over to the DNS forwarder. And what does the DNS forwarder do? It just turns it over to your computer. Just like the DNS full resolver did, it turns that record back over to your computer. So now your computer has the A record and it can do the things that it wants to do. So you may be wondering at this point, what's the point of DNS forwarding? Why does it exist if all it does is forward on to another DNS resolver? Because it still has to go through the full resolution process. What is that doing for us? Well, it takes a little bit of work to run a full resolver. So we have these much simpler systems to set up, the DNS forwarders, and what benefit do they provide? They provide the benefit of being closer to you. So you can have a DNS forwarder running in your house. Like I said, a pie hole does it, your router might do it, your ISP might do it, and they're very close to you. And all that does is give you a cache that's closer to you that saves you time in the future because, again, we're limited by the speed of light and distance matters. And if you're sending those requests all over the world, then it takes time for those things to be resolved. So we can put that cache in your house even to have that closer to you if you need it. And it's simpler to run the forwarder than it is to run a full resolver, although not, it's not also not super complicated to run a full resolver should you so desire. It just takes, you know, intent. You have to want to do it to do it. And that's the DNS resolution process. That's what every single DNS message goes through, as long as it's not already in the cache. If it's in the cache, obviously the server's just going to return it from the cache. But if it's not in the cache, then it has to go through that full resolution process somewhere along the line. So before we go, check yourself. How does the DNS resolver do its job? And if you know that, then you understand the DNS resolution process.